how to spot the ISS.
The International Space Station is one of the most incredible technological and scientific experiments ever attempted by humankind. Since the launch of the first module in 1998, the International Space Station has grown in size and complexity, and it now has as much living space as a six-bedroom house. Were it here on the ground, it would fill an American football field, which makes it really easy to spot from your backyard. The ISS is only 350 kilometers above our heads, circling the planet in low Earth orbit. This means there are plenty of times that you can watch the ISS fly over your head, but there's a catch. You'll have to have good timing. Oh, look, there it is. The ISS doesn't emit enough light to see it all the time, but it does reflect the sunlight just like the moon does. This means you can only see it when it's above 40 degrees up from the horizon. If you stretch out your arm and you make a fist holding it vertically, that's like 10 degrees. Because it's moving so fast, the best way to spot the station is to use NASA's app or website tool, aptly called Spot the Station, though there are plenty of other apps and sites that can help you as well. Once you figure out where to look, head outside and get ready for the show. At the appointed time, the ISS will look almost like the lights of an airplane, but won't have any flashing or twinkling. Unlike stars, which are stationary but appear to move because of the rotation of our planet, the International Space Station is in orbit, completing one trip around the Earth every 90 minutes. It's like flying from New York to LA in 8.5 minutes. Sounds awesome. At that speed, the ISS is only sometimes visible and only for a few minutes. But if you're vigilant and you know where to look, it's actually hard to miss. The ISS has to move fast so it can stay in low Earth orbit, or LEO. LEO is a common and easily accessible orbit. The Hubble Space Telescope is in LEO, as are communications, military navigation satellites, and the now retired space shuttles could move things to and from LEO, but no further. Low Earth orbiting objects are essentially in free fall all the time. They're going so fast that as they fall, the Earth's surface curves out of their way. Y'all, once I was lucky enough to spot the ISS flying overhead while at a sunset Pacific beach bonfire. It's one of the moments that hooked me on naked eye astronomy. It was so compelling that others joined me to stop and stare as it flew silently over our heads. It was beautiful. Thanks to the ISS, we've had a constant human presence in space for almost 20 years. We've been able to complete thousands of scientific experiments in that time. NASA is set to retire the station in 2024, so if you're gonna spot it, you better get out there and keep looking up.